Hi, I didn't see you there. I've sort of lost my concept of time with this whole virtual classes thing. And I wasn't really expecting Cabaret to start for another hour or so. Nonetheless, here we are. My name is Zack Finacchio, and I have the absolutely stupendous privilege of being your host for the evening. Or afternoon, or nighttime, or that weird part of the day where it's in between morning and night around 2 a.m. and you're not quite sure what time of day to call it. The international students know what I'm talking about. Regardless of what time you're watching this at, I am so excited to welcome you to the Valentine's Day Cabaret. I know you must be disappointed about the virtual format this year, but on the bright side, it's a lot easier to fast forward past my commentary, and I can now do this. Alright, now that I'm properly dressed, I've bantered on long enough. Allow me to introduce our cabaret's opening performance. Rodgers and Hammerstein's 1945 musical, State Fair, follows the Franks, a small-town farm family on their big trip to Des Moines, Iowa for the, you guessed it, State Fair. While there, the family's daughter, Margie, finds herself falling head over heels for a boy named Pat, and after a wonderful few days together, she waits for him on the darkened carnival grounds. She soon begins to reflect on their relationship and all the lessons she has learned firsthand. Performing The Next Time It Happens is one Miss Ashley Gelber. Goodness that with this virtual format, that performance can happen more than once. Because I know I'll be rewinding to watch it multiple times. Up next, we have Amelia Roselli, taking us back in time and across the world from 1946 Iowa to 1916 Russia. This musical, based on a children's movie of the same name, takes us on a journey to the past, beginning with the capture and eventual execution of the Russian Romanov dynasty. However, when rumor spreads that the young Grand Duchess Anastasia may have survived, two con men find an amnesia-ridden doppelganger to the Duchess named Anya and intend to use her to scheme their way into fame and fortune. Dark plot for a kid's movie, I know. However, here, using her light and beautiful voice to describe Anya's amnesia, is Amelia Roselli, singing In My Dreams from Stephen Flaherty and Terrence McNally's Anastasia.
Darkness and cold with the wind.
Words of the band 5 Seconds of Summer. I wish that I do not wake up with amnesia like Anya and forget about that sensational performance. Anyway, this next song is from a Christopher Smith musical, loosely based on the life of eventual priest and abolitionist John Newton, most famously known for writing the song Amazing Grace, which doubles as the name of the musical this song is from. In this next performance, Kate Dillard, most famously known for starring as Auntie Em in her 8th grade production of The Wizard of Oz, will portray Mary Catlett, John Newton's childhood friend. Amidst the violence and horrors of this musical's plot, I Still Believe serves as a heartwarming break where Mary sings aloud a letter she wrote to John, recalling his childhood spirit. Please give Kate a warm welcome as she performs it for us. I must say, after that performance, I still believe you are incredibly talented. And speaking of talent, this next performer has loads of it. While I have no Hun army for her to fight, although I'm sure she would give the local private school a run for their money, she is ready to get down to business to kick butt on this next song. From Alan Menken's iconic Disney film Mulan, this song finds our heroine downtrodden over her family's expectations of a woman. Please, transport yourself with me to a koi pond in Imperial China to enjoy Kwama Ankrah's performance of Reflection. If I were Leia Salonga, I'd be scared for my job after that performance. And that is not a sentence that I take lightly. Much like Mulan, this next musical also centers around tradition. While you may best know this musical as the inspiration for Gwen Stefani's Rich Girl, it more importantly explores Jewish tradition and Father Tevye's relationship with his daughter's weddings. In this next song, daughter Hodel explains to her father that her true home is wherever the man she loves is. Without further ado, performing Far From the Home I Love from Bach and Harnack's Fiddler on the Roof is Kaj Dongre. Kaj, that performance will have me singing yiddle deedle 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 da for the next week. On another note, this next song is at the top of my soothing Broadway playlist. Once, the movie-turned-musical by Glenn Hansard and Marketa Irglova tells the story of two creatively named characters, Guy and Girl, when they meet in an Irish pub. While he is reflecting on his past relationship and former passion for music, Girl convinces Guy to sing her the song she finds in his jacket pocket. For this performance, however, a girl will be playing Guy as Jessica Lee sings her calming rendition of Falling Slowly.
Thank you. spirits that take me, and he raise me, and I'm painted black. You have suffered enough, and warred with yourself. It's time that you
point, you may have noticed that I am the only male you've seen thus far on the screen. And as a matter of fact, every singer tonight is a woman. Theoretically, for a similar ratio, you could just go watch an episode of The Bachelor. But I promise, none of our performers are as dramatic as Queen Victoria. They may, however, show a similar level of heartbreak, especially with the acting chops of this next singer and the emotional depth of her song selection. One of my favorite musicals of all time, The Last 5 Years by Jason Robert Brown, follows the 5-year relationship between Kathy Hyatt and Jamie Wellerstein, from their first date to the moment Kathy finds a letter from Jamie describing his series of affairs with other women. Fascinatingly, the story is told from each character's unique perspective. Kathy's going in reverse when she finds the letter, and Jamie's starting with their first night together, running chronologically and meeting in the middle. Performing the opening number of this heart-wrenching musical is Gabby Medina, with Still Hurting.
Jamie arrives at the end of the line. covered with scars, I had nothing to learn. Maybe there's somewhere a lesson to learn, but that wouldn't change the fact, that wouldn't speed the time. Once the foundation's cracked, and I'm still
after watching that performance, I cannot imagine why you could possibly need any more explanation as to why I am a firm member of Team Kathy. However, if you would like to discuss it, I would be glad. Fortunately, this next number will be one to lift your spirits. Starring former Hamilton star Philippa Sue, the musical Amelie by Daniel Massey and Nathan Tyson follows the young ingenue Amelie, who, while working in a Paris cafe, becomes bored with her own life and orchestrates love and comedy into the lives of others. As a director and technical extraordinaire for Periwig, our next singer is no stranger to creating worlds of her own, much like Amelie. The following song finds Amelie reflecting on her life and abundant creativity. Please welcome Eleni Lefakis singing Times Are Hard for Dreamers. Eleni, I must say, with a performance like that, as hard as times may be, you make it look easy. Now, our next performer is no stranger to the cabaret stage. She graced us last year with her rendition of Art Is Calling Me, complete with a floor-length golden dress and black boa. While this year she may lack the glitter and feathers, her performance is sure to dazzle nonetheless. Her song takes us to 1862 Siam in The King and I, a Rodgers and Hammerstein classic. In the musical, the British schoolteacher Anna is brought to Siam to tutor the king's children. Eventually, the king and Anna reach a heated confrontation over the title and limits of her role as a tutor. After the argument, the king's wife, Lady Tiong, explains to Anna how the king's frustration mainly stems from how barbarically he is portrayed by Western culture, hoping Anna will forgive him. Please enjoy Idaya Chambers singing Something Wonderful.
This is a man who thinks with his heart. His heart is not always wise. This is a man who stumbles and falls, but this is a man who tries. This is a man you'll forgive and forgive and help and protect as long as you
Idaya, that performance was truly something wonderful. Now, if you don't know the plot of this next Disney musical, you clearly were not in America in 2013, because the story of sisters Anna and Elsa took the country by storm. Quite literally. 5 years later, Kristen Anderson Lopez and Robert Lopez adapted the score for the Broadway stage, adding in hits like the following song, which occurs near the end of the musical, once Prince Hans has locked Anna in a room alone, expecting her to freeze to death. While, as a result of the pandemic, Frozen on Broadway has recently closed, Delaney Musgrave will help it live on with her performance of True Love.
I've sat alone in this room before, hours and hours on end. I know this delusion, no wish the door would open to reveal a friend. I know this solitude, I know this kind of cold, but I had faith in what the stories told of true love. How I'd find true love. Here I am in this room again, just as lost and You don't know what it is. And now it's clear I'll never leave this room. It ends as it began, with no one but myself to blame. I played my part in the plan. Dreaming got me here, and yet the dream won't die. I can't wish it away, no matter how I try. True.
Delaney, I love that performance so much, I never want to let it go. And now, before our final spectacular performance, there are a few people that I must thank for putting this together. First and foremost, thank you to Mr. Palmer, Mr. Rockley, and Mr. Cafaro for assembling this astonishing group of performers and organizing the event. Additionally, I'd like to give a shout out to Mrs. Burns and the Allegro Council for all of their work behind the scenes of the cabaret. Moreover, I am so grateful to Lawrenceville's private vocal instructors for training and preparing our performers for their selections. And of course, I can't forget to thank Mr. Fink for all of his star-dazzling piano playing over the years. Finally, thank you to all of our performers, and to you, for making it through my commentary thus far, or at least fast-forwarding quickly enough to get to our very talented singers. Virtual or not, Lawrenceville is not Lawrenceville without your commitment to our campus community. And now that I'm done being sentimental, it is time to welcome our last performer. You may have seen her as star-to-be in her 8th grade production of Annie, or as Miss Scarlet in our fall production of Clue on Stage, for which I learned a British accent, but it's in our best interest that I don't speak in it too often. Now, she will bless us with her performance of No One Else from Dave Malloy's innovative musical Natasha Pierre and the Great Comet of 1812, based on Section 8 of the novel War and Peace. In this number, Natasha leaves her home, finding herself deeply missing her fiancé Andre. For our final performance, prepare to be blown away by Anjali Kumar singing No One Else.
We've done this all before. We are in
Thank you so, so much for watching, and I hope you stay well. I cannot wait to rejoin all of you on campus in March. Bye.